tomorrow we have the Safeguarding Sport from Corruption Conference, and what we're trying to do here is to help sports organizations, government, media, civil society understand the threats that are unique to sport when it comes to corruption, for example, legal betting, competition manipulation, but also show them how to overcome those threats, the tools that are available, the type of networks, the partnerships that they can link into that will help them look at that problem.
I think the main objective really is just to get people together to update and talk about where we are dealing with corruption in sport, but also to look at new ideas and look at the ways in which we can tackle the sport more efficiently going forward.
To tackle corruption in sports, we definitely need to strengthen a pragmatic approach of the Resolution 7-8 to go into deep and pragmatic actions, more cooperation, more collaboration together between governments and sports organizations.
As corruption is a criminal matter, it is a responsibility of the governments to implement the necessary instruments to fight corruption at national level. Yet it's also the responsibility of sport organizations to respect best practices in terms of governance, including gender equality, in order to mitigate the risk of corruption.
So what we're trying to do is to create that type of forum where we can create awareness around the problem of corruption in sport, but also try to find and talk about some of the solutions.
Both governments and sports organizations must work hand in hand, as that's the only way to fight corruption in sport.